We will move on to our next speaker, who is Dorian Kaufman, who's going to tell us about a challenge, and we're very excited to hear about that.
Yes. Hi, everyone.
Hi, Dorian. Please share your screen and take it away.
Yes. Thank you, Ashta, for inviting me today. And I'm Dorian Kaufman, the challenge project for the France Managing Challenges project. I'm part of the FBI Challenges team with Emmanuel Faure and Guillaume Guy. And we have the advices of Edouard Bertrand and Thomas Walter and Christophe Zimmer. So, France Managing, as you maybe know, is the French node of Eurobioimaging, and this is a national infrastructure for biology and health in France. So, as is France Managing, and its main role is to facilitate and coordinate research in bioimaging all over France. So I'm part of, with my team, of the FBI Data Mission, which organizes one challenge per year to offer useful tools for biologists. So just before going further, I will just make some reminders, because what is a challenge? We can simply define a challenge in the data science context as a data science machine learning competition where the best analysis code wins. So this is very simple. And why we want to do challenges? Simply to develop powerful methods and to create standards for benchmarks. And for example, you have CELPOS and STARDIST, which are very famous tools which train their algorithm on a famous database of famous challenges, which is the Data Science Bureau 2018. And so this is very interesting to do challenges in this context and to develop databases, open databases. And so, why France Managing wants to organize challenges? Mainly because it federates much than 20 acquisition sites all over across France, and it's have a structuring role with many of the acquisition sites, and wants to bringing method back to biologists because they don't have made. They don't have to go further in a Python context or something else and go faster in their jobs. So, what are we doing? So, for defining the first challenge, we want to go through the needs of the biologist, as I've said before. So, we finally define a problem to solve. With survey and some meetings with the platform supervisors to a problem to solve. So, how can we obtain 4 common organelles on living cells by fluorescence microscopy without the constraints of the acquisition process? Sorry. So, in accordance to obtain fluorescence microscopy images, it is necessary to perform a manual biochemical labeling, yes, which is time-consuming and costly, costly and time-consuming, sorry, over the cells with specific probes and dyes. So here, we want to focus about nucleus, mitochondria, tubulin and actin, because the cells studied may themselves be perturbed by both the light exposure, such as, for example, phototoxicity, and by the probe themselves. For example, you have a cytotoxicity problem. And this is very important for live microscopy to limit the number of probes. This is why, for example, you see, you have 4 organelles. On the contrary, transmitted light microscopy is label free and it is non-invasive and the phototoxicity is sharply reduced and the signal quality is conserved. So this leads us to the first France Blue Imaging challenge, which is light micelles challenge, and its aim is to recover fluorescence images by computer from transmitted light images. So we asked to the France Imaging biologist to acquire both transmitted light and fluorescence images of, for example, here one cell. Then we have the input and the ground truth images, and so the algorithm have to predict here. The algorithm have to predict from the transmitted light images the four organelles in fluorescence. And then this is a task in data science, which is called image to image. And the predictions at the end will be what the state of the art called in silico labeling, which is simply a computer labeling method to avoid this manual annotation and the drawback I've said earlier. So we have seen the biological motivation and the main aim of the challenge, but what are the bioimage analyst motivations? So you have seen about the sports multi-output deep learning method, for example, and we want, of course, to develop a robust tool about various acquisition protocol and other cells, instruments, and markers. And after this, we hope maybe to have new architectures on algorithm and deep learning models, and maybe new loss functions to learn about, I don't know, some only a few tools or etc. And we want to go through the open data process with open source and fair data. We put a lot of effort into conserving the metadata with open source algorithms, because the winners can receive prizes only if the algorithm will be open source. And we are in the process with Bioimage Archive to publish the train database. So now we have the motivations, the objectives, and we can go a little bit further on the basis of all the challenge, which is, without a joke, the database. So here, there are a few examples of position and images of the train database, and thanks to the structuring role of France Imaging, we have a train database with more than 57,000 images over more than 30 different acquisition protocols with the metadata associated and standardized, because all the metadata are for an bioimage analyst foundable, yeah. So how we organized this train database? So here we divided all images into several Z planes and for all channels. So at the end we have only 2D images, and here you have on the 2D images with several planes in fluorescence. However, for biologists, this is not useful and not practical to have blurred image here, for example, with blurred nucleus. So we choose to focus to choose the best focused organelles. We choose We choose the best focus fluorescence images to the trained data. So here we have one image, and after you have to predict all the other image at the best focus. This is a little bit tricky, but I hope you understand. And for example, here you have here, and for that for each images you yes. So this is like that natural data augmentation. So after that, for the test, you have the participants will have to predict the four outputs, even if we don't have, for example, actin in some images. And this is secret, and just the organizers know about this. And we choose to evaluate these images about some common metrics. This is very common. And to put texture metrics on nucleus and mitochondria. Yeah, so I don't want to explain much more today, but you can access at the challenge, because we are hosted by Grand Challenge. And now we are probably a lot of participants. So this is very, very good. And we are accepted at ISBE 2024. This is the International Symposium on Biomedical Imaging. So in Athens. So we are very proud. And you can go here. Yeah. So we are just sorry about the timeline, because since we are accepted at ISBE, the deadline are very short, and the registration are open until March 30, as the phase one, which is test phases to understand the process of submitting algorithm and dockers on Grand Challenge. So all the participants will have five submissions, and after the final test, which only one submission to win or not the challenge, and the announcement of winner will be at ISBE 2004. And for the prize are on the website page, but for the top three winners, of course, code support and integration into the Open Science Bioimage software, as we want to help biologists, such as Bioimage Model Zoo and Napari, for example. And the invitation to publish into the proceedings of ISBE, and the challenge paper as a co-author with the paper of the challenge. But at the end, this project involves a lot of people and many various professions, without which it will not, it sorry, just a few problems with my English. Not possible with all data contributors. So I just want to make a very big thanks to all the data contributors from all the nodes in France. The challenge support team was a big help. Alban Belloir for the very huge logo, amazing logo, and the communication. Mariana for the communication at UBI. Guillaume Mocor for his advice, and all my colleagues. And thank you very much for your attention.